The following is a presentation of CBS Sports.
1 year ago, it was the closest championship in NCAA women's gymnastics history. Top seed Alabama led going into the final rotation, but had to watch as Utah made a late charge while defending champ Georgia felt the pressure.
Leah Brown falls for the second time. And for Georgia, they're out of it.
It all came down to Utah's All-American Amy Trepanier. Her confidence level was topped only by her miraculous score of 9-9. That gave the University of Utah an eighth national championship by 5/100ths of a point, denying Bama once again.
Utah has won the 1994 NCAA championship.
And they're all back for an encore. It's the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. Welcome to the Georgia Coliseum on the campus of the University of Georgia in Athens. This is where Lady Bulldog fans are hungry for a title. They have even dipped into the alumni club for support. Herschel Walker and Georgia AD Vince Dooley have gathered with nearly 8,000 fans. This is the 1995 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships. Hello, everyone. I'm Andrea Joyce. Well, this is an annual meeting of an elite club. Only three universities have ever won the NCAA team title: Utah, Georgia, and Alabama. And even though the defending champion Utah is going after an impressive ninth championship, the attention here is focused on Georgia and Alabama, and a rivalry that has reached epic proportions. These two teams really don't like each other. Time now to bring in our analyst, 1984 Olympic gold medalist, Julianne McNamara. Julianne, what about this Georgia team? They come in top ranked, and they've got thousands of fans barking for them. How much of an advantage is it?
Well, Andrea, this team is so strong, I don't really think they need a home court advantage, but it can't do anything but help them. They're led by senior Agena Simpkins, a seven-time All-American, and I feel the spirited leader of the team with her spunky personality and extreme talent. Also, Lori Strong, a two-time Olympian for Canada, obviously a seasoned international competitor, and can only bring valuable experience to this team.
Now, despite that strength, though, Alabama has been able to beat Georgia twice this season, most recently at the SEC Championships. What does Alabama have to do, though, to be able to win here?
They must have spectacular performance by the entire team, and especially Kim Kelly, their team leader, who scored three perfect tens on the vault this year. And they may be looking for Georgia to falter. The nature of this sport is who hits on the day that it counts. And if Georgia falters, look for UCLA. I think they've looked really impressive this year. And let's not forget the defending champions, Utah.
And the top six teams in the country, the Super Six, compete for the team title. There you see the two SEC powers also in: UCLA, Oregon State, Utah, and Michigan. Six women compete per event, with the top five scores counting toward the overall team total. The four apparati are the vault, the uneven parallel bars, the balance beam, and the floor exercise. And in the first rotation, it's Bama on the vault, Michigan on bars, Utah on beam, and Oregon State on the floor. UCLA and Georgia have byes. So that means that Georgia coach Suzanne Yocklin and company will leave the floor for the time being. And Alabama coach Sarah Patterson already with her game face on. First up, it's Alabama on the vault. Kim Kelly's first vault scored a 9.925. Here's her second attempt. Only the highest score counts.
Here's a pike front and a great landing. Kim's a very strong vaulter.
She's a junior. She's had four tens on this vault. And that effort by Kim Kelly, good for a 9.95, and she gets the tide rolling. Over on the floor now, Rondi Miller of Oregon State, a sophomore from Vancouver, Washington.
Rondi opened up with a double pike back, good landing. Set setting up for her second pass. Whips through to a double twisting layout. Nice job.
Nice performance by Miller, but we should point out Oregon State has already had two shaky floor performances that has virtually taken them out of the championship contention already.
Rondi has had a very clean performance. Her last pass, a double twist. Very well done.
Some very dedicated Oregon State fans. They made a long trip here, and Miller gets a respectable 9.825. Coach Jim Turpin with a congratulatory hug. Over to the beam now, and Utah's Suzanne Metz.
A beautiful back handspring, layout back handspring.
We should point out there are four events going on simultaneously. There you see the floor exercise going on in the background, and that's what the music is for, you're hearing. Utah's the top beam team in the country, and Suzanne Metz is the best of the best, top ranked in the country.
And what a great event for a team to be the best at, because it's so difficult to compete on. A little wobble there, that'll just be a small deduction. Remember, the beam is only 4 inches wide. It's 4 feet off the ground and 16 feet long. Very difficult to compete on. Gainer full twist dismount.
Suzanne Metz, so dependable for the Utah Utes.
This is a beautiful tumbling run here. Right into a laid out backflip immediately. Backhand springing out of it. Perfect landing.
And that's good for a 9.85 for Suzanne Metz. Beth Weimer of Michigan set for her bars routine. Weimer, the Big Ten Gymnast of the Year.
Watch these giant swings with a full twist here. Right into a pike front flip, a release move. She does an excellent dismount, a full twisting double back, and a nice landing.
Nice job by the senior from Toledo, Ohio. Michigan's goal this year is to crack the top three, and that's a 9.9 for Beth Weimer. And early on, Michigan is in third place. Alabama leads Utah in second. Well, the Bulldogs are anxious to get going. Michigan happy with that start, and we will be back with more from Athens after this.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1995 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship is sponsored by Buick, the new symbol for quality in America. Old Spice Sensitive Aftershave. And by Gum Out. Before you try and tune up, try Gum Out first.
Welcome back, everyone. Georgia coach Suzanne Yocklin trying to forget last year when her team lost the national championship on the beam, and that is where the Bulldogs will begin their quest for redemption. Also in this rotation, UCLA on vault, Alabama on bars, and Utah is on the floor. First up for Georgia, freshman Julie Ballard. She wasn't around for last year's debacle. Maybe that's part of the strategy, Julianne, in starting her on the beam.
Well, coaches usually don't like to start freshmen first on this event because it is so difficult. There is such a small margin of error. If you're just slightly out of place, then that could be it. And look at that, just right out of alignment, big fall, 5/10 deduction.
And as Julie Ballard gets back up on the beam, why don't we head over now to the uneven bars. Here's Stephanie Woods of Alabama, the Crimson Tide, hoping to build some momentum after a strong first rotation.
Stephanie is a beautiful bar worker. There's a staller hop. You don't see that very often anymore. Look at the long, beautiful lines, pointed toes. The one thing Stephanie is missing is a release move. There's another Staller circle. Setting up for double pike dismount.
Well, Sarah Patterson says Stephanie is the rock of this team, and she gets the job done here on the bars. A 9.875 for Stephanie Woods.